would like to discuss some functionality of the Capsman in the microtik, but not only. For me, the goal, the challenge would be to have to bring the microtik inside of some enterprise to do some big installation with the microtik wireless and microtik controllers. So we are Italian distributors. We are also Switzerland partner here, mostly in Italian region and Italian Switzerland. Also, we are we have Y4Net .it website for e-commerce and sales of our products and the microtik products. Also, we support technical support for providers and enterprises and companies to improve, to introduce the microtik functionality. I am working with microtik since 2006. I was the first man in Prague. I also opened the academy now in Italy. So the idea is to have the Capsman, to introduce the Capsman in some enterprise environment, and the idea is to study with some coverage tools before deploy all the system, then discuss about the Capsman functionality and features, how to configure and how to use some setup. And then have some extension of the Capsman in the network, in a wireless network, like a hotspot for home device, for example, and have the total control, the user control of what is happening inside of the network. The first is planning the network, and then install, deploy, manage, and control. It means the flow is before of going to install. It is better to have some planning tools, some plan of what I have to do in order to have a better control of all done. We have developed some tool and plan for planning and optimization. This is we call the white form up, and the idea was to study what we can do for better channel planning and better wireless coverage. So we developed some specific tools like there are on the market, but this was developed by us with some algorithm, and also some outdoor point-to-point calculation. The channel planning was an idea to have better deployment of automatically deploy of the channel, setup of the channel. Sometimes the channel are made on the same frequency with some problem in use of the access point and the better use of the system. So we use an algorithm with some heuristic functions with change with the study of all possible channels and their access point and their position on the map, and we studied how to have a better deployment on the system. So our software use a map of the installation. You put the access point in the place and it studies the better channel configuration to deploy on the network and propose, for example, from one position, from one channel, it changes it to the other channel with less usage. Of course, some channels can overlap, and the system tries to limit it as much as possible. Only between the far routers with overlapped channels. And some percentage of the real bandwidth can be calculated in order to see how much the expected the percent of the bandwidth will be available, like 92%, because some frequency are of course in the near channel, You know that on the 2.4 bandwidth there are only three non-overlapped channels, so it is always difficult to work in a big installation, many access point installation, wired installation, as well in the 5 GHz. And so we use some other tools. We calculate another tools with the ray tracing algorithm to deploy the coverage. So before we plan the channel and where to put the access point, and then we studied how to have the better coverage and calculate the signal expected in every place of our map. So we have a map inside of the system. We deploy the signal loss on the walls. We have to set up some kind of wall, and the software calculates the signal expected in the room near the access point or far to the access point, in order to have a better plan before going to install the access point, so I can move on the map and calculate again to see which is better to deploy. These are our tools before the installation. Then we have to install it. This is not related for this, but it's outside tools for point-to-point calculation. We have done Wi-Fi tools. It is free for usage. Just connect and enter your email. You can use calculation for link planning, free space automation, Google Map-based tools. Okay, so we have planned how to put the access point, where to put in our map, in our in our building. Now we have to deploy it with the CapsMan. The CapsMan is the software made from MikroTik for centralized AP management, provisioning, remote firmware update, with some functionality for Mac and AP layer communication, certificate support, and other functionality and configuration. The CapsMan is the server that is the controlled access point system manager. Can be a router OS device with or without the Wi-Fi, the wireless card, so you can use CRS, we can use a CCR, we can use also a simple access point, and the cap is the controlled access point, so a router OS wireless device. I can run both this on the same machine. The CapsMan and the cap can be on the same machine. I can use a CapsMan on a small router board 951, because the software is very low consumption of low CPU usage, or use a bigger router CCR if I have hundreds of caps to control. CapsMan already has two versions, because the version one has a short life. The V1 started from router OS 6.11. I installed the first CapsMan on router OS 6.18, because the first version was very under development. But now, since the router OS 6.22 started the version 2, they changed completely. So the version 2 is not compatible with the version 1. You have to change all the CapsMan and the caps to use the same upgrading, because the version 2 introduced some improvement and new feature. The most important features of the version 2 is the possibility to upgrade the remote caps from the CapsMan. Before, it was not possible to upgrade an access point from the central CapsMan. Now it is possible with the version 2, so it is better to use the version 2, and it is working. Now we are on router OS 6.30, it is working well. The setup is quite easy. Let's see some slides on how to set up the CapsMan. the capsman, after we have installed the capsman, whose package is called Wireless CM2, is the name of the packages, that is now included in all the packages of the router OS download, but is disabled. We have to enable to see the Capsman version 2. The version 1 was included in the wireless FP packages. If you remember, what the first part included the Capsman version 1. The CM2 is the package for the Capsman version 2. Just enable on the button Capsman manager, enable the server to start to configure it. And other a simple configuration is very easy. Just go under configuration, press the plus button, and use only one form to complete the configuration. Because from the wireless, I set up the SSID, the name, and for example, the country. In the data part, I set up a bridge where all the radio data or the CAPS data arrives, where all the data will converge. And the security, for example, to set up some kind of authentication, WPA with encryption. This is enough for the first configuration. Just do all on one form. I can also create separate configuration for channels. Okay, I was telling I can also configure separate form for each security config or each data path, and then choose in the main cap configuration, but is the same. I can also use it inside of the same configuration. I call it the master configuration. So at the beginning I have to create one configuration. Then I have to enable the access point to be managed by the capsman. So on the access point, there is a button on the wireless that is a button cap. Just enable it and choose which interface will participate will be managed under the capsman, and the discover interface where the access point is going to search the Capsman server. The Capsman, the CAP can find the access point through local network or also layer 3 network, so routed network, by using the Capsman addresses, and that will go, will can also traverse NAT when required. In a local network, I can also work with the CAPS man and the CAP without any addresses on the CAP access point. Just enable it, write down the name of the CAPS man address, the CAPS man name, and the access point will find the server. In a more reliable network, of course, it is better to use just the address to find the server Capsman. The client can be managed also by a certificate, but client data is not secured under on the data traffic, only for authentication. Then we have to set up a provisioning rules to manage all our access points, the CAPS access points. So we have enabled on the server, we enable on the client side, we have now to deploy and go under the provisioning to have all the access points running under the CAPS. First of all, the system search for radio MAC, so it accepts every MAC address by writing 00 on the radio MAC. Then the main parameter is what to do, create, enable the CAPS, can be created dynamic or disabled or enabled. I always choose the create enabled, which is the most stable for me. I choose the master configuration just made before, and if I want to give some name of incoming cap, that is, I can choose from identity just the name cap or the other parameter, the prefix. I also can add some prefix, but the beginning is to add a configuration and create a provisioning rule. After the provisioning rule, the CAPSman and the CAP access point will start to collaborate, let's say, and be managed. On the access point, I will get the wireless disabled because with the red lines managed by the CAPSman with all the information. And on the server side, on the CAPSman, I will see one row with the name of my access point, MicroTik 1, what is deploying under their radio side. So running access point with that frequency, power, and so on. If you see from the server side, the regulatory domains, Switzerland allows for 20 dBm power, but I configured different antenna on my single access point, and I see here there are only 12 dBm power. The antenna is another parameter to be declared on the single access point on the CAP. Then I want to add a virtual access point on my network. For example, I have one secure network for my internal personal one, another secure network with authentication on a trusted server, LADAP or internal window, and I want to add some kind of guest configuration, for example. I have to come back to the provisioning rule and change and add, sorry, a slave configuration from the only, not only the master configuration, but I can add a slave configuration. And as well is allowed to add more than one slave configuration. So I can add several virtual access point to my configuration, my CAPS configuration, CAPSman configuration. For example, in this print screen I made with our dual radio access point, 2 and 5 GHz, we had two separate virtual access point to every radio. So we have done every cap for 2 GHz and one cap for 5 GHz with two separate SSID, one for teacher, one for student, for example, in this case. I have made another one with 4 SSID, one trusted, and 3 separate guest login on same access point. Other functionality is the load balancing group, which is just a field on the CAPSman data path form, which allow to balance user within other access point in the same group. This is a hidden functionality because it's not so documented. We tried and studied how it works, and it works quite good. Bans the user until there is more than access, more user on another access point, try to register on the less used access point in the same group. So the system balances it if they are near access point, but they are full of users, it balances it on other access point in the same room. Roaming, it is working, it is not documented. I don't know how is working the roaming from one access point to the other. We can ask to the technician, but it is working. If you move from one access point to the other, even in a big CAPSman network, you are still connected without any problem on your client side. Then we can do, if we want, some manual adjustment of settings. For example, I have to change a parameter in an access point in a cap. Just go on, sorry. Just go on the parameter for my caps. Register on the capsman and change. I can change here some manually. The cap is registered. Will be modified on the caps access point, but I can change if I need for something. As well, I thought just before, the antenna gain must be configured previously on my cap and before the cap provision, because it's a parameter that can be modified on the cap. When you open up the button cap, enable the cap on the access point, the radio are not usable, is disabled, you cannot modify anything except the antenna gain. Okay, we can enable on the CAPS manager the certificate for a trusted connection with the access point and the CAPSman is auto-generated from the CAPS manager. We can see down here and on the CAP side, just require the certificate and will be exchanged between the endpoint. Okay, some pros and cons of CAPSman. For example, it's easy to implement large number of access points at no cost. The concentrator has no license limitation. We can use a 951 access point or a big CCR to set up hundreds of access points. We have configured 80 access points with the dual radio, so 160 caps with the two SSIDs or what. Are 320 Wi-Fi SSID deployed in the network without any problem on CCR. It is working stable and working good. It's tunnelized for layer 3 control, so I can have geographically access point remotely connected in layer 3 and concentrate and manage all from one only CAPSman in my data farm, in my office side, and it is working. The roaming within access point. Something to be improved and to have better functionality, we can ask also to the MikroTik technician. A way to control power if we have crowded areas of user and the access point are not yet at the same level, the customer can move within access point to the other because it finds a better power in the other side. If some access points or if some caps will go out for a problem, any kind of problem, there is not an alarm. There is no an alarm to signal that we have problem on access point is no more working. And other things will be, this is more hardware than functionality. I need a radio to check, to have the control every time on an access point, what is on the air that the access point can move the power and move the users if there is an hidden radio that study and control the environment. Okay, these are something on the CAPSman. Now I want to add some kind of control on guest users, for example, just add a slave configuration, and so I see before on my provisioning on the, so I add another configuration that is called slave. I will disable the client-to-client forwarding for the guest user, because everyone doesn't have to see each other, and and put it inside of a bridge hotspot, for example, Totalcon, and open up a hotspot on the MicroTik. Then I want to control my guest user not only but with the hotspot, but with different authentication, with different bandwidth limit, with different usage and time limitation, and so on. And the MicroTik itself is not able to do all of these things. So we have to develop an external Radius server to manage all the hotspot user and the authentication that are requested on the market now from the customers, especially for different authentication, but also for different usage limitation. We call it Wi-Fi spot. Is our hotspot system completely developed by us. It's a MicroTik based because all the gateway is a router board machine who runs the hotspot. So on the Capsman machine, just add an hotspot and it is ready to be managed for the hotspot server and provide a social login with easy setup, authentication of accounting, and also extended logging for every kind of request that complied for police request and privacy laws. We have encrypted tunnels because from our machine that is on the gateway machine or the access point control, it was running on a data server through tunnel and are managed centrally on the server. This is made for the request. For I have to use my own device inside of the network. I can enter on the secure network, just use the hotspot with a separate login. We can also add the content management filter or request to stop request on external categories of website. And we have added some simplified panels to enable the disabled user group or office or subsidiary home office or some kind of guest users. Everyone has a simplified panels, which is managed by administrators or managers of the networks. For example, on the user, they are enabled or disabled by their user profile with a simple button. But one of special things is I can enable or disable in some period of the days or also for some limited time. So I need for 1 hour, 3 hours, 4 hours, or I need until 1 o'clock p.m. I can just set up this, and the hotspot will be after that disabled at all, or just use it from Monday to Friday, and only on Saturday morning. This is a functionality which is very well appreciated from enterprise, from the company, because of they don't want to leave some guest user to enter outside of the working days. Of course, we had to add the social login. The social login now for hotspot are the most requested because of user doesn't want to register and they have any other, let's say, complicated process. The social login is easy with your Facebook, Twitter, or LinkedIn account to enter on the system. Of course, we maintain all the login and user control, but the trusted, so to be sure of the user that is on the network, the only way, as we presented a lot of time ago, is to use an SMS control, so use the mobile number of the user for have the complete control of, to be trusted that that user is one physical person registered by the police department, say, oh, with a credit card, with a, sorry, with a identity card, I have to give for my mobile number. But now the level of hotspots so deployed in, outside the inside of the network that in every organization the social login are accepted for use the guest account. Okay, my conclusion is that with the MikroTik indoor solution we can use it with the CapsMan inside of every enterprise to deploy secure and complicated network. Also big installation are possible with minimum effort to control the user. Provisioning and firmware update is possible from a centralized management, and also guest users are handled with hotspot. Social login or time login are managed, of course, with external tools because of the limitation of the basic software tools. Thank you for your attention. Any questions?
It sounds like you have a lot of devices hanging off like a single CapsMan. So how do you handle single point of failure?
With the CapsMan, to redundant the CapsMan, you mean? It is possible to have a redundant CapsMan. You have to use some trick because it's not prepared to be redundant the CapsMan. So the MikroTik doesn't provide the package for redundant of the CapsMan. You have to use some configuration externally on the machine, but it is possible. Any other question? Thank you for all.